Thank you for listening. My name is Mike Strauss, aka Strauss 21. I'm a mixed martial arts journalist. I currently contribute to BJPen.com, Lowkick MMA, CageSidePress.com. You could find my work there as well as my YouTube channel at aka Strauss 21. And of course, the Did You See That Shit Mixed Martial Arts podcast that you are listening to right now. Here is my latest interview. I hope you enjoy it. I want to welcome back Mr. Rafael Lovato Jr. to the show. Unbeaten. Man, I swear to God, Rafael, you are incredible. You look better and better every time. I know that's the goal, but you truly look the part, man.
Well, thank you. Doing my best. I have a great team and just working hard.
I mean, you're incredible. That last fight against Salter, that was a close fight going into the last round there, but it seemed like a switch flipped, and you weren't going to let it go to the judges, man. What did your corner say to you in between round two and three to get you to take it to that next level, or did they say anything at all?
No, they didn't have to, really. Obviously, they're giving me some technical advice. I'm really in the zone, so I'm kind of in my own head in between rounds. Obviously, I listen, but I'm also thinking about, you know, what I felt and the adjustments that I want to make. And going into the third round, all I kept telling myself was, you know, that I needed a big round. And I was really just like motivating myself and telling myself to push as hard as I could, going into that round. I felt like as the fight was going on, I was getting more comfortable and coming on a little stronger. In the second round, whenever he was working hard to take me down and kind of defending a guillotine at the same time, I felt like he used quite a bit of energy in that exchange. And, I just felt like as the fight was going on, I was kind of going up and maybe he was going down a little bit. So I was confident that I could get a big third round. And, you know, I just gave it everything I had. And fortunately, I was able to get on top. And once I was on top, I was very confident that I would be able to finish it before the time was up.
Yeah, I don't know if anybody could hang with you on the ground. I mean, truly, it's remarkable, man. It's fun to watch, you really, because you came into your own and you are truly now a complete mixed martial artist. But I wanted to ask you, man, I mean, we saw you face some adversity in the Honeycutt fight and you came through that, you know, with, you passed that test with flying colors, and now Salter. Which fight do you think was more challenging for you? I mean, obviously you won both, but what do you think tested you a little bit more?
Oh, definitely the Salter fight. John, obviously he very, very tough, competitor, and, you know, like he had a great game plan, him being a southpaw, being close to my size, as far as the height and the reach, with Honeycutt, I felt really comfortable on the feet, with him, just the fact that I had a good reach and I don't think he was too comfortable in going to the ground with me, whereas Salter was. So, as far as Salter getting on top, trying to take me down, you know, Salter was able to defend the guillotine really well. For me, Salter was definitely the tougher fight. He was landing some good shots on the feet, his southpaw, he had some good angles and he was landing some good leg kicks as well. I think we both were connecting with some good shots, but it was really even. He's not as hesitant to try to take me down, being, you know, great on the ground and able to see and recognize any danger. So, I think most people had it one round apiece going into the third. In my mind, I felt like I was like maybe down by two, you know, and I really wanted to, you know, have a big third round. So, in the Honeycutt fight, I never really felt like I was too behind. But with Salter, I felt like, you know, I could be losing this fight right now.
Yeah, for sure, man. And, you know, the Mousasi fight with MacDonald, that was pretty impressive what Mousasi was able to do. But what I think was very cool is after the fight, Mousasi took to the mic and he said, yeah, Lovato's the next guy. And this is the second time or third time he said that now. So I think that's very cool that, you know, the champion, the best guy in the world is totally acknowledging you as the number one guy. Has your rise to the top, man, has that even came a little bit quicker than you thought it would?
You know, it's definitely a little surreal. You know, I imagine this, like this was my vision to fight for the belt in Bellator, you know, with maybe around four or five fights in. And so I'm, you know, right on that time schedule. But, you know, it's just crazy to now be here, and Mousasi's the champ, and you know, I've earned my number one contender spot. And you know, I think it's, you know, going back to what you said, you know, he can literally pretty much fight whoever he wants. You know, if he was sitting up there at the top and just said, no, I don't want to fight Lovato, I'll wait for Machida, you know, Bellator, there's a great chance they're gonna do what he says, being the star power that he has, and you know, wanting to give him the fight that he's motivated for. So if he was saying that, you know, I would probably get stuck in limbo somewhere. You know, nothing is finalized yet. Still waiting to get the word on, you know, what the next fight's going to be, when, where, and everything. But I have a really good feeling that it is going to be against Mousasi, because, you know, he's saying he wants to fight me. And, you know, just so much respect to him for, you know, seeing the work that I've done and saying that I do deserve the shot. And, you know, I mean, arguably he has more control than what Bellator has. So he's basically giving me the shot. You know, I think, nothing is set yet. Obviously the Carvalho and Machida fight is, you know, Machida is the one person that could get in the way. So we'll see what happens, but I think it's coming true, man. And it's going to be an honor to step in the cage against Mousasi.
Yeah, that's so cool, man. And, you know, what I think is really cool about it is that Mousasi, as you said, man, he could really fight anybody he wants to. And he's not taking the easy road by any means. I mean, you, by all accounts, are the scariest guy in that division right now, in Bellator. And he is not shying away from that. So that's very cool. Hats off to Gegard. How do you think that you match up with Mousasi?
Well, obviously, you know, I mean, he's one of the best of all time, between middleweight, light heavyweight. I mean, he's got to be top 10 all time. You know, he's super well-rounded, very technical, very relaxed. You know, I think obviously with everybody that I face, I believe in my jiu-jitsu, I believe I have an advantage on the ground, and I think that stands with him. And he's going to have an advantage on the feet. You know, he's definitely got some of the best striking out there. Very crisp. You can see his jab that, you know, that really kind of just took MacDonald out of the fight. I think the jab was, you know, what made him decide to kind of go out there and pull guard and try to get into that leg lock. You know, he's just really relaxed and, doesn't waste energy. You know, and he's going to use his stand up and basically keep it on the feet. You know, it's going to be kind of a kickboxer versus grappler. Whereas Mousasi is also a well-rounded, you know, grappler as well. I think he would try to avoid those situations with me. And, you know, it'd be a tough fight. It'd be a very, very tough fight. You know, just like, I've kind of been thinking about it nonstop already. And, you know, it's going to motivate me a lot, and I'm going to be as ready as I possibly can to get out there and do my thing. But, you know, it's just, you know, it's crazy. My 10th fight going against a legend like him, it's, you know, unbelievable.
Yeah, it's remarkable, man. And, you know, history is on your side, I guess, right? Because grapplers usually fare pretty well against the strikers, as we just saw, too, right? So that's a good thing. But, you know, as you said, Mousasi is a capable grappler, but nowhere near the level of a Lovato Jr., that's for sure. Before I let you go, man, what is your thoughts on the Fedor and Chael fight this weekend?
Yeah, actually this weekend has both. They have a double events, Friday and Saturday, this week. And so, the final four are you're going to get the finals of the heavyweight Grand Prix. You know, my heart's with Fedor all the way through. I really would love for Fedor to win. You know, it was so awesome getting to fight with him in Chicago and just being, you know, around him and, feeling his aura. But, you know, he's, you know, obviously like probably everyone's favorite as far as, one of the all times, you know, you get in to watch him, back in the day in Pride. And I mean, he's, just amazing. And so I want to see him win and kind of finish off his career on top and, do his thing. But man, Chael, you know, it wouldn't surprise me to see Chael's arms getting raised. Chael's a very smart fighter. You know, he's got the wrestling. I mean, even though Fedor's bigger, you know, there's a good chance that Chael's going to be able to put him down, and control him. So it's a tough fight, but, I actually like Chael too. You know, Chael, has been very nice to me in the past when I talked with him. So two great guys, you know, it's going to be a close fight. On the other side, I'm definitely leaning towards Bader. So, you know, if I had to put money, I would say Bader is going to win the whole thing. But my heart's definitely with Fedor to go all the way through.
Absolutely. Me too. I echo your sentiments exactly, man. Fedor has my heart, and I think Bader probably, if I'm using my head, I'd probably go with Bader. Well, I appreciate your time, Rafael. I know that you're super busy lately, man. You're everywhere. I know that your academy, your school there is doing phenomenal. I see you on social media. You're doing big things, man. I'm super excited for your next fight, whatever it may be. Hopefully the Mousasi fight, but either way, I'm sure it's going to be a great one. I'd like to give you a few minutes here. Shout out your coaches, sponsors, whatever you would like, man. Floor is yours.
Sure. Well, thanks for having me on again, Mike. Mm-hmm. Appreciate the support. And yeah, shout out my sponsors, Word Tribe Gear, On It, Brookover Enterprises, White Equipment Rental, and Cryco. My school in Oklahoma City. You know, you guys, anyone comes through that area can look us up at okbjj.com. And shout out my team, Ebulu Santai, Hibeto Jiu-Jitsu. I appreciate all the love and look forward to, you know, going all the way to the top next interview. Hopefully I'll have that belt by then.
Well, I appreciate it, Rafael. Enjoy the rest of your week, man. Take care.
Thanks, Mike. Take care.
Bye-bye.